Alexa, how many days until March 19th?
Tuesday, March 19th, 2024 is in 24 days.
So we're about 24 days from my board's part one exam. I decided I wanted to try to document this just because of how horrible this is. I've talked to my teachers about it before, and they said, oh yeah, for sure, this is the hardest it'll get. It'll get easier after this.
Summer 2023 was the second rainiest summer on record for Boston, Massachusetts. With only 5 rain-free weekends from Memorial Day to Labor Day, it's safe to say that anyone who needed the sun or just dry outdoor time to recover from the winter was left unsatisfied when September rolled around. And in one of the older buildings of Greater Boston, a 24-year-old student was deeply, deeply unsatisfied. Because summer 2023 was the only time to feel human between the unforgiving optometry school second-year spring semester and the fall, where the two-year dreaded battle against the beast began. But that boss battle was in the distance back then, still hazy behind the fog above the mountains, miles away. Something to learn about, understand, and deal with later. But at the end of that summer, it was suddenly close enough that we could start making out the details of it. And now the clock was ticking to get those details clear.
Fall semester was very interesting. I definitely did not feel like myself at all. I feel like I was acting so weird. I was not acting like myself. I had been talking to a friend of mine about it at that time, about this like weird snap that, about this like weird snap that kind of happened in me in fall semester. I was doing so much stuff that wasn't good for me. I was making decisions that were not good for me. The semester just started, you know, my board studying hasn't even really started yet. Like, why am I acting like this already? And she was the one who actually told me, it sounds a lot like maybe you're having a really extreme version of the Sunday scaries, but instead of like Monday that you're dreading, it's like the entire board school year because of like this thought of like, you're gonna have to do boards this year. And she was absolutely correct. That is something that I don't think anyone knows about that kind of happens at the beginning of third year, is just that dreading. Because boards is honestly more of a mental game than a studying thing. It really is. Like, it's all about where your mind is at.
That semester, I had a really high course and clinic load. It was literally like running a marathon for the entire semester. My friends and I were like, how on earth are we supposed to be studying when we have to do this? So along with the really high stress of what was going on in the semester, we also just had the severe lack of board studying to be worried about, which came together to create the perfect conditions for rock-bottom mental health.
I obviously planned to start in September, but then my classes got crazy right away. We had 5 or 6 classes in the fall and 2 days of clinic, so immediately it was crazy. And some of the board's prep plans said to start in October, so I was like, okay, I'll start October 1st. But then October 1st came, and in 2 weeks it was midterms, so then I was like, okay, after midterms, I'm definitely gonna do it. But then after midterms was November, and then that we had all of our KMK weekends that month and also a ton of seminars and such that had been pushed after midterms. So then I was like, okay, I haven't started yet and the semester is about to end. So then finals happened in December, and then I started my board studying properly the entirety of winter break. I was studying between 8 and 10 hours every single day of winter break, and I didn't even take a day off from when the last final was. It was literally last final, I traveled back home and immediately started studying for boards all day, every single day. And that's not good, because by January 1st, the KMK recommendation is that you've been through all of your materials one time. And I had, at that point, been through about 3 pages. I'm not even kidding you.
Although the break was lower stress than the fall semester, it really wasn't much of a break at all. Then spring semester started, and it was game time.
Basically, my method for spring semester was that I attended every single one of my lectures in person and tried to focus and be present and listen as hard as I physically could during all of those lectures. And then when the lectures were done, I would not study for them outside of class whatsoever before midterms or before boards too. So I was literally just locking in during all of the live lectures, and then afterwards I would only be studying for boards. And this is exactly how I did it.
On my Google Calendar, I scheduled when every single one of my classes, labs, and seminars were, which is normal for me, as well as gym time, what time I would need to leave to get to school every day, what time I needed to wake up, and exactly how much time I was allotted to get ready for the next task in between each of these. I also scheduled when I needed to take the train home, just in time to give myself an hour to get ready for bed and sleep. I scheduled 9 hours of sleep into every single day because I unfortunately would stay up past my scheduled bedtime. This created a very chaotic looking schedule, but it ensured that not a single minute, except on weekends, was going unaccounted for. I focused all of my studying at the beginning with reading the KMK book. Hours and hours of reading, taking my time with each section to really understand. I was able to justify my gym sessions by listening to KMK videos instead of music, which was actually really good for me because it's hard for me to sit still and focus on videos. I also deleted Instagram and YouTube from my phone because of how dry and overwhelming the amount of boards prep was. I couldn't allow anything more interesting than review material to be a part of my life, or else I would be distracted constantly. I was already a study machine coming out of the fall semester, but I reached new levels of inhuman during this time. I quickly discovered that I absolutely needed to make time to pray and be in the Bible to keep my sanity. If I didn't at least do this, I just wasn't going to be able to keep up with this study schedule all the way to boards. This entire section of the semester is now a complete blur to me. I feel like there's about 2 months missing from my memory. The only thing I can easily remember now is working out at the gym and wanting to listen to music so badly, but resisting. And then it was March. The pedal was to the metal. Everything for the past 3 years led up to these last 2.5 weeks.
Hello, don't mind my skin. I'm really sleep deprived because of studying. It's March 8th today, which means the board is in about 11 days. Here's my little iced coffee I've made with the, what is it called? Milk foamer, I guess. I was not gonna come home at first because I was like, I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to study at home, and like every second counts at this point when you're this close to the board. But I'm actually really glad that I came home because I don't think I realized how much I needed to be, you know, rejuvenated with nature and stuff like that. Just taking a breather. I just took a mock exam today. I did pretty decent on it actually. There was a few sections, like several sections, that I actually got like 100% on, which is really promising. So, to be honest, the sun is in my eyes. To be honest with you, there's a lot of people in my class who've already decided to postpone their board to August. I'm gonna be squinting this whole time. The sun is really bright. And I can't go through this again. I cannot add even one more month of this to my life. I feel like I've been on survival mode for like 7 months. Last semester, I like really truly did not breathe. And I barely could study boards because of how difficult the didactic is. And I will say, like, because some people have reached out to me about how NECO does with boards, I absolutely do think that NECO teaches the material on the boards really, really well. Everything was familiar, you know, everything was relearning for me. There was only a few things that I was like, I'm not sure if I ever learned this before. However, I mean, fall semester, there was no chance of being able to study outside of the didactic classes that we had, to be honest with you. They were so... It was a lot of didactic, and also I had 2 days of clinic last semester, and I had 2 days of clinic this semester, and the clinic ends about the week before midterms, which leaves you with about a week and a half to study for the board. So in terms of time at NECO, time that is completely clear of studying for your didactic classes, and also clear of doing clinical things, which does take quite a bit of the week, right? I have a friend who is doing 18 hours of clinic per week as a third year in this semester, which is crazy because this is our board semester. They leave you about a week and a half beforehand to study for boards, which is pretty small. So I will say, like, if you're considering NECO, I love NECO. I don't regret my decision of going to NECO at all. I love it there. However, that one specific part of NECO is pretty difficult. That is a difficult thing that they do. I deleted Instagram, Snapchat, YouTube, off of my phone. I've checked them every once in a while using like a browser, but like I've kind of like basically learned to live without them, which is like a good thing in one hand because I'm not like just consuming junk. Like it makes me laser focused on boards, but it also makes it feel even more like boards is my entire life, which it needs to be, of course, but I don't even know what it's like to not be just living for boards anymore, you know? I'm gonna have to kind of readjust and start contacting friends again afterwards, start like kind of making the effort to communicate with friends and communicate with all the other parts of myself, you know, to just remember like kind of who I am before this process started, or who I was before this process started. I almost have these kind of moments of up and down confidence about the test. So I'll have those moments of like, yeah, I feel like, you know, I'm in a good place for this exam. And then I just have these moments sometimes where I'm just like, I can't fail this exam, you know, and I haven't done enough, or, you know, like all of, I have so many classmates who have done like so much more than me, you know, they bought the signature KMK package, which is not what I bought, or, you know, they got through all their opto prep questions, and I've literally hit like 1/10 of the opto prep questions that I bought this opto prep thing, barely any of the opto prep questions. I have a lot of classmates who are like hitting the 80% mark, which means that it's going to renew if they fail. So for me, if I were to fail the exam right now, my opto prep would not renew. In all the time leading up to boards, it definitely feels like if you don't pass it that first time, so if I don't pass it this upcoming, you know, boards time, then I will be shot. Like, that's literally what it feels like. It feels like if you don't pass, you're going to die and everything ends for you. I know that that's not true, you know, but it's just like nobody talks about what happens if you fail. Like, nobody really talks about how that process kind of looks. The whole idea is just don't fail. Like, that's the whole thing. It's just don't fail. And we don't need to know what happens if you don't fail, right? But then that makes the stakes just so much higher, and the cost of boards plus like how long you have to wait to retake it, and, you know, the cost of all the prep materials, I mean, it makes the stakes so high, and the cost just keeps going up. And the more expensive that they make this, and the more expensive they make the materials, and the harder it is, and all this different stuff, the stakes just keep going higher and higher and higher. And I just don't know how much more stress I can take, you know? I feel like I said, I feel like I'm going to die if I don't pass. Of course, the beautiful weather only comes when you have to study all day. It's like 60 degrees. I don't know if this makes sense, but I can feel the end coming, and the end being my no longer being able to study. All right, boards is in 2 days. So that means tomorrow, no studying. I'm gonna rewrite all my optics formulas one time, and that's all the studying that I'm allowed to do tomorrow, because you should not study the day before boards because your brain is already not working. Why make it work even less right beforehand? It needs to rest, right? Just doing my skincare routine right now. I've been having a recurring dream that I walk out of boards during the middle break that you get, because you basically do 4 hours of exam, then you get a 45-minute break, and then you get four more hours of exam after that, and then you're done. That's how long the board is, so it's an 8-hour exam. But I've had this recurring dream. I walk out and I'm like, oh, that feels so good, you know, boards is all done. And then I realized that I had like a whole other half to do, and I like had just walked out. I didn't like go back in to do the other half, and like they wouldn't like let me back in and everything. I've had this dream like 3 or 4 times already. I thought it would be good for me to kind of talk about my dreams that I've been having, just because I do think that, you know, these are all part of the experience. I've also been having just the recurring dream that I didn't show up, like I forgot my board, you know, so like I'm going to do something else, and then my friends are like, where were you, you know, like it was yesterday or something like that, and I had forgotten to go to it. My sleep really has not been peaceful at all. I stay awake so late into the night, and then I just continually wake up throughout the night, and I've tried to kind of get myself to wake up earlier to study early so that I can get in the academic brain earlier in the day. My skin is getting worse. I've been like kind of out of control eating. I've been eating so much bad stuff too. Like I just have these like crazy cravings for just sugar and junk food and stuff. And I think that it's because of stress, or at least I hope so, but it stinks because, you know, obviously my body is not looking its best, which is not even something that I should be worried about with something like boards, but what can I say? I feel like just a lot of things kind of stacking on top of each other for me right now. I really don't know my stuff well enough right now. I'm worried about it. I don't know if you can hear me, but they recommend that you go check out the place that you're going to be taking the test, like whatever prometric you're taking the test at, before the exam, so that day of you don't run into any problems where you might not know where it is, or if you go to the wrong one or anything like that. I just visited it. It was in that building that I just took video of, and now I'm going home.
Okay.
Okay guys, I hope you're pumped for today's pre-boards workout. I'm your host, Michaela Callahan, and I'm gonna guide you through how to definitely relax and take your mind off of the board that's happening in less than 24 hours. Today's the first day off you've had in months, so let's start it out with a workout. We're starting out today with a few sets of deadlifts. That's gonna be 5 sets. The number of reps is just gonna be until whenever you just can't do it anymore, or like whenever you get bored, that's fine. Next, we've got one of my personal favorites. It's the hack squat, okay? We're gonna do 5 or 6 or maybe 7 sets of however long you want on the, don't think about that. Push that thought away. Let's get back to our workout, right? As I was saying, we're going to do a few sets of hack squats. Try to get as low as you can. You should already be feeling kind of tired, but I'm gonna keep pushing you, okay? We're gonna do some hip thrusts next. Try to do like 3 sets of these. You don't need to do an insane amount because the other two were really, really hard. I understand. Up next, we've got the good old fashioned hamstring curl, okay? I love when the hamstring makes like a little bump. I love that. So we're going to do like probably, I told you to stop thinking about that stuff. Push that out of your mind. This is supposed to be your relaxation day, okay? Stop. Stop it. Okay, anyway, as I was saying, the hamstring curl is just such a nice exercise to do. When you get back home from that, why don't we just clean the whole house, okay? Let's just rearrange everything, clean up everything, you know, things are all over the floor. And we want all that stuff to be all cleaned up. And no, we're not gonna do that. Okay, so we're gonna head down to the store. Yeah, let's go to the store. We're going to grab a sandwich. We're gonna buy a sandwich because we have no food in the house. We haven't gone shopping in weeks. So we're gonna have to buy something if we wanna eat. Yeah, the sandwich has protein, it's got vegetables, it's got complex carbs. So this is gonna be a really good nutritious lunch. Hey, what did I just say? Stop thinking about that. This is supposed to be your off day. Stop thinking about that. Anyway, back to our workout. And you might be thinking, this doesn't really seem like a workout anymore. We're doing other things. Well, then why has my heart not stopped beating so fast?
Alexa, how many days until March 19th?
Tuesday, March 19th, 2024 is in 2 hours and 46 minutes.
It's 5:30 a.m. the day of the test, and I did not come this far just to come this far.
So it's been 2 months since I took boards. If you're planning to like use any of the tips that I gave for boards, I will let you know that I did pass. That does not necessarily mean that my study method is gonna be the same as yours, or that like our results are gonna be the same. If you do the same thing, make sure that you still do what you know is gonna work for you, but you can probably take some tips here and there if you know that it'll be good for you, right? I will also say that like now that, you know, time has passed and the results came out and they were good for me, and you know, third year kind of ended, a lot of the stuff that I was saying was very much just my anxiety coming out. So I wanna make it very clear that no, you're not gonna die if you don't pass boards the first time. There are tons of amazing, great doctors who did not pass boards the first time. That's totally okay, okay? It's actually really normal nowadays to not pass boards the first time. So don't let those comments that I made
affect you, because those comments were towards myself, you know what I mean? That was just my own anxiety talking. But thankfully I am past it. I am now in Florida. It's really beautiful here. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed watching. Sorry it was really long. I hope maybe some of it was helpful to you, or just at least interesting. If you like these types of videos, like and subscribe. I am planning to post more now that it's fourth year and I don't have as much like academic stuff to do. Like the time of optometry school for me that is really hard is starting to kind of come to an end, which is really good. See you guys on my next video. Thank you for watching.